shift work has become increasingly common. 3 out of 10 Canadian workers now work shifts that are outside of the conventional workday. So today, Ruth West from the Grey Nuns Hospital joins us to look at some of the nutrition issues that shift workers are facing. Because it's not easy to stay up all night and try to figure out how do you eat your meals.
Exactly. It's not easy, and it really does affect how you feel. So it's worth paying attention to what you choose, especially when you're working on night shifts.
And so how does staying up on a night shift affect your body? I would feel like you'd be hungrier.
Well, I sometimes find people are sort of eating 24/7 that way because they're up all night and they're eating through the day too. But basically, what affects you is the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm that sort of is a daily cycle that we all have that governs what we call our internal temperature. So, you know, if you think about it, your body temperature actually increases. And that wakes you up. Sort of early in the morning, it increases and you wake up. Later at night, it falls and you tend to go to sleep. Mm-hmm. So we're governed by this circadian rhythm. It also governs the digestive system. And unfortunately, the way I put it is the digestive system is always on day shift because that circadian rhythm, of course, has it functioning normally during the day, but it slows it down at night. And no number of night shifts are ever going to change that or alter that circadian rhythm. You can maybe nudge it by a few hours, but you're never going to be able to really truly change it. So your digestive system is always on day shift while you're trying to work night shift.
Right. So to eat your breakfast at 8 and your lunch at 12 and your dinner at 5 or 6, does not work. So when should we be eating the main meals?
To go with that circadian rhythm, what people usually do is they have their main meal of the day when people on day shift have their main meal of the day at between 5 and 7 at night. Mm-hmm. And that's a good time to have it because especially if you're having higher fat foods or heavier foods, your digestive system is working normally. It's a great time to have that main meal. Mm-hmm. When you get to your night shift though, you want to be eating light at night and choosing lighter foods for a lunch and certainly lighter snacks. And then for breakfast is now before day sleep. Breakfast is going to really have an effect on how well you sleep through the day. And needless to say, sleeping through the day is a challenge at the best of times. But if your breakfast is really heavy, high fat foods, it fractionates your day sleep. If it's lighter, like I've got pictured here, cereal, fruit, juice, then that helps enhance your day sleep. So that's a really important thing to think about. What am I having right before day sleep?
Right. Don't put your digestive system into action right before you go to bed.
Exactly.
Okay.
But in terms of during the night, eating light means eating lower fat foods because higher fat foods really do make us feel more sluggish, you know, and we know that. And higher fat foods actually end up slowing down the digestive system even more, which you don't really want to be doing in the middle of the night.
No.
So, you know, the typical night shift, I sort of think of night shift workers as often getting cravings for things like, you know, chips or donuts or pizza. Those are all high fat foods. Not the best choice, really, for your digestive system. So what I've got here is more of a lighter lunch, lean meat sandwich, some veggies, some fruit, low fat milk and lighter snacks like low fat yogurt and fruit.
And a ton of people also are grabbing the coffee in the middle of the night and all day long,
and
I suppose.
And do you blame them? I really don't blame them because the caffeine in the coffee helps them to stay alert. But the problem is that caffeine stays in your body for about 8 hours.
Right.
And so that can affect your day sleep. So the general recommendation is to try to cut off caffeine-containing beverages about 4 hours before your day sleep. Typically, if you're on night shift till 7 or so, your day sleep might start at 8 or 9 in the morning. So try to keep that in mind. You know, cool it on the caffeine-containing beverages after about 4.
And grab some water instead.
Well, water through the night shift makes a difference, just like it does in day shift, because if you get dehydrated, you start to feel more tired. So water being well hydrated keeps you more alert.
Perfect. Okay. Some good tips. Thanks, Ruth.